मनुष्य जीवनलाई सार्थकता एवं उद्देश्य प्रदान गर्दछ कि मनुष्यको बन्धुत्व भावना राष्ट्रहरूको प्रभुसत्तादेखि सर्वोपरि छ कि आर्थिक न्यायको सर्वोत्तम उपलब्धि स्वतन्त्र मनुष्यको व्यावसायिक स्वतन्त्रताद्वारा हुन सक्दछ कि शासन व्यक्तिको होइन विधिको हुनुपर्दछ कि वसुधाको महान निधि मानव व्यक्तित्वमा निहित छ कि मानवताको सेवा जीवनको सर्वोत्तम कार्य हो। धन्यवाद। जय जय
यसै सन्दर्भमा विगत 2014 देखि हामीले मिस एसएलसी 16 सम्म र 17 18 19 मा मिस एसी गरिरहेका छौँ। यो मिस एसी गर्ने क्रममा हामीले विविध थाले सहभागीहरूलाई 10 विविध थाले टाइटलहरूबाट सम्मानित गर्ने र फाइनलमा हामीले फर्स्ट विनर फर्स्ट राउन्ड सेकेन्ड राउन्ड घोषणा गर्ने भनेहरू। आज हामी यो मिस ट्यालेन्टको छान्ने प्रक्रियामा छौँ। भरान जेसिसले विविध खाले 10 यस कार्यक्रममा पनि 10 टाइटलहरूमा योभन्दा अगाडि मिस ब्युटिफुल फ्रेन्डसिप फोटोजेनिक र विविध खाले अन्य पनि हाम्रो जजमेन्ट भइरहेको यहाँलाई हार्दिक जानकारी गराउन चाहन्छु र कतिवटा त हामीले रिजल्ट प्राप्त गरिसकेका छौँ। त्यो जजमेन्ट कम्पिटिसनमा छ। आज पनि हामी हाम्रा 30 प्रतिस्पर्धीहरूमध्ये आफ्नो क्षमता के अवध छ, आफ्नो सबभन्दा के बढी ज्ञान छ भन्ने कुराहरू सोधेर हामीले विविध 3 विषयमा सहभागीहरूले आज प्रस्तुति गर्नुहुनेछ। यो सह प्रस्तुतिमा निर्णायकज्यूहरूले निर्णय दिएपछि हामी ग्रान्ड फिनालेमा यसलाई घोषणा गरेर पुरस्कारबाट सम्मानित गर्ने गर्दछौँ। त्यसै अन्तर्गत सम्पूर्ण भाइ बहिनीहरूलाई आफूले जे जेमा प्रस्तुति गर्ने हो त्यो अत्यन्तै भव्य सभ्य र राम्रोसँग प्रस्तुत गर्नुहोला। सम्पूर्ण सहभागीहरूलाई म शुभकामना दिन चाहन्छु। अलिकति समय धेरै भइसक्यो भने म धेरै कुरा नराखी पुनः एकपल्ट सम्पूर्ण सहभागीहरूलाई आफ्नो प्रस्तुतिमा ध्यान दिनको लागि र अत्यन्तै राम्रो ढङ्गबाट प्रस्तुत दिनुभएको राम्रो गर्दै सम्पूर्ण सहभागीहरूलाई विजेताको शुभकामना सहित मेरो भनाइ यहाँ पठाउँछु। धन्यवाद।
कमिटीका डाइरेक्टर जेसी अमर राईज्यूलाई म नियमहरूको बारेमा जानकारी गराइदिनुको निमित्त विनम्र अनुरोध गर्दछु।
जेसिसले आयोजना गरिरहेको यो मिस एसई 2019 यो जजमेन्ट कमिटीको तर्फबाट यहाँलाई हार्दिक म न्यानो अभिवादन व्यक्त गर्न चाहन्छु। वक्तित्व कलाको निर्णायकको रूपमा हुनुहुन्छ बिबी श्रेष्ठजी हो। उहाँले त्यसै क्रममा नृत्यतर्फको जजमेन्टको रूपमा जज रहनुभएको छ वनिता तामाङ। अर्को विधा रहेको छ कविता र हामीले आज निस्ता कवि देवान किरातीज्यूहरूले आजको यस कविताको जजमेन्ट गरिदिनुको लागि हामीले निम्त्याएका छौँ। अब भने म उहाँहरूले कसरी जजमेन्ट गर्नुहुन्छ भन्ने कुरालाई अगाडि पस्न लागिरहेको छु। जम्मा 3 जजहरूले 300 मार्क्सको 100 मार्क्स गरेर 300 मार्क्समा उहाँले जजमेन्ट गर्नुहुनेछ र ओराटरीतर्फको जज गर्नुहुने जजले 70 मार्क्सको उहाँले दिनुहुनेछ। 70 मार्क्समा एड्रेसिङमा 10 मार्क्स, आई कन्ट्याक्टमा 10 मार्क्स, सब्जेक्ट म्याटर कस्तो रहेको छ त्यो सब्जेक्टमा 20 मार्क्स, प्रेजेन्टेसन कस्तो हुनेछ भन्ने विषयमा 10 मार्क्स, उहाँको गेस्चर पोस्चरमा 10 मार्क्स र कन्क्लुजन कसरी हुन्छ भन्नेमा 10 मार्क्स गरेर उहाँले 70 मार्क्स दिनुहुन्छ भने उहाँलाई हेरिरहनुहुने जज गरिरहनुहुने कवितातर्फको जजले 15 मार्क्स र डान्सतर्फको जजले 15 मार्क्स दिएर 100 मार्क्सको जजमेन्ट हुने या सहभागीहरूलाई म जानकारी गराउन चाहन्छु। त्यसै गरी डान्सतर्फ प्रस्तुतिकरणमा 10 मार्क्स, ताल र सुरमा 25, वेशभूषामा 10, स्टेज कभरेजमा 10, हाउभावमा 15 रहेर उहाँले 70 मार्क्समा निर्णय गर्नुहुनेछ र उहाँले नृत्यतर्फ निर्णय गरिरहँदाखेरि वक्तित्व कलातर्फको जजले 15 मार्क्स र कवितातर्फको जजले 15 मार्क्स दिनुहुनेछ र गरेर 100 मार्क्सको रहनेछ। त्यसै गरेर कवितातर्फ भाव र विचारमा 30 मार्क्स रहेको म जानकारी गराउन चाहन्छु र त्यो कवितामा कला र शैली कस्तो रहेको छ त्यसमा 30 मार्क्स, प्रस्तुतिमा 10 मार्क्स गरेर 70 मार्क्स चाहिँ कोइनतर्फको जजले जजमेन्ट गर्नुहुनेछ भने वक्तित्व कलातर्फको जजले 15 मार्क्स र नृत्यतर्फको जजले 15 मार्क्स दिएर तपाईँहरूको मार्किङ हुनेछ र उक्त तिनैजना जजहरूबाट प्राप्त भएको मार्क्सलाई हाम्रो एउटा यो मिस एसए 29 को जजमेन्ट कमिटी छ, जजमेन्ट कमिटीको एडभाइजर र म डाइरेक्टर सर देखिसक्नु भएको छ। हाम्रो एउटा समिति छ, त्यो भित्र हामी समितिको व्यक्तित्वहरू बसेर त्यसलाई कम्पाइल गर्नेछौँ र कम्पाइल गर्दाखेरि जसको हाइएस्ट मार्क्स आउँछ, हाइएस्ट मार्क्स अप्टेन गर्ने सहभागीहरू बहिनीहरूलाई नै हामीले आउने ग्रान्ड फिनालेमा टाइटल अवार्डले हामी सम्मानित गर्ने यहाँहरूलाई जानकारी गर्दैछौँ। त्यसै गरी समय भन्ने चाहिँ 5 मिनट रहेको छ, ओराटरीलाई 4 मिनटमा जनाउ घन्टी बस्नेछ र 5 मिनटमा चाहिँ लास्ट घन्टी बस्नेछ। तर कवितातर्फको भने समय तोकिएको छैन, डान्सको चाहिँ 3 मिनट रहेको यहाँलाई म जानकारी गराउन चाहन्छु। 30 जना सहभागी बहिनीहरूले जित्नुहुनेछ भन्ने कुराहरू यहाँ राख्दै म बिदा हुन चाहन्छु। धन्यवाद, जय जय श्री।
सहकार्यमा हुन लागिरहेको टेस्टी टेस्टी मिस एसी कार्यक्रमको आजको यस टैलेंट कार्यक्रम में उपस्थित हुने संपूर्ण धरान जीसीस का पदाधिकारी जीवहरु धरान जीसीस का पूर्व अध्यक्ष जीवहरु धरान जीसीस का प्रथम महिला भाउजूहरु सदस्य जीवहरु तथा सहभागीहरु र सहभागीका अभिभावक जीवहरुमा म एकपल्ट फेरि धरान जीसीस की महासचिव जीसी आयुष्मा साक्य न्यान अभिवादन व्यक्त गर्न चाहन्छु। ट्यालेन्ट रमलाई हामी अगाडि बढाउन लागिरहेका छौँ र म निम्त्याउन चाहन्छु मिस एसी पार्टिसिपेट कन्टेस्टेन्ट नम्बर वानलाई। उहाँलाई आएर आफ्नो परिचय दिँदै आफूले नृत्य गर्न लागु भएको नृत्यको बोल भन्दै आफ्नो नृत्यलाई प्रस्तुत गरिदिनुको निमित्त म निम्त्याउन चाहन्छु कन्टेस्टेन्ट नम्बर वान, प्लिज जोरदार ताली दिनुहोला।
नमस्ते एभ्री वान, आई एम अनिसा श्रेष्ठ कन्टेस्टेन्ट नम्बर वान representing Mount Hermon Children Academy, Kami Pokhari Moura. I believe culture is the identity. It is the diamond song of every individual. So I am going to showcase my talent in the form of a dance named Hijorati Timi Bari Dekhi Sapani Ma. Thank you.
Thank you. name is Kiljaran, and today I'm going to perform a dance, and my dance song name is Nindi Nevitna Laudina. Thank you so much.
Thank you. छ मेरो त्यसैले त अरूको भन्दा पर कहानी छ मेरो नमस्ते भरा म रजनी लिम्बू प्रतियोगी अखबार आजका यस सभामा आदरणीय निर्णायकज्यूहरू साथै सम्पूर्ण अतिथि महानुभावहरूमा न्यानो अभिवादन टक्र्याउन चाहन्छु देशका लागि मर्ने युवा देश विकासका लागि मर्ने युवा देशलाई राष्ट्रियदेखि अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय स्तरसम्म पुर्याउन जुनसुकै कुर्बानी दिन सक्ने हामी युवा आजको यस सभामा जोड्दैछौँ सारा युवालाई भन्ने शीर्षकमा आफ्नो मनोभावनाहरू व्यक्त गर्ने अनुमति चाहन्छु युवा र राष्ट्र एउटै सिक्काका दुई पारा जस्तै हुन् त्यसैले आजको यस सभामा महिलाहरूमा युवा भनेको के हुन् त आखिर युवा को हुन् अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय मानव सङ्घले 18 वर्षदेखि 40 वर्ष उमेर समूहका व्यक्तिहरूलाई युवा मानेका पनि मेरो विचारमा ती युवा होइनन् 18 वर्षदेखि 40 वर्ष पुग्दैन कोही युवा बनिँदैन हजुर कोही युवा त तब मात्र बन्छ जब कसैले आफ्नो व्यक्तिगत स्वार्थभन्दा माथि परिवार परिवारभन्दा माथि समाज समाजभन्दा माथि क्षेत्र अनि क्षेत्रभन्दा माथि जब कसैले राष्ट्रको बारेमा सोच्छ हो बल युवा हुन्छ राष्ट्रियता राष्ट्रियता अर्थात् राष्ट्रप्रतिको मनोभावना यो कुनै भावनाले व्यक्त गर्ने कुरा होइन यो त आफ्नो गर्वले गरेर देखाउने कुरा हो मानौ कुनै ग्यालीमा आफ्नो देशको राष्ट्रिय झन्डा बोक्नु मात्र राष्ट्रियता होइन राष्ट्रियता त त्यो हो जहाँ आफ्नो देशलाई मुटुमा राखेर देशको उन्नतितर्फ लाग्नु राष्ट्रियता हो देशको प्रगतितर्फ लाग्नु राष्ट्रियता हो हाम्रो देश नेपाल एउटा विकासोन्मुख राष्ट्र जुन कछुवाको गतिमा विकासको बाटोतर्फ लम्बिरहेको छ आखिर किन किनकि हजारौँ दक्ष युवा जनशक्तिहरू अरब गएर खरब कमाउने सपना बोकेर विदेश पलायन हुने क्रम बढ्दछ यदि ती युवाहरूमध्ये करिब 50% युवाले मात्रै आफ्नै देशमा बसेर श्रम खर्च गर्ने आँट गरेको भए सायद अहिले मेरो देश नेपाल अमेरिकाभन्दा विकसित भइसक्थ्यो अनि सायद हामी नेपालीहरू अमेरिका जानु होइन अमेरिकाका मानिसहरू नेपाल आउन डिबी भरिरहेका हुन्थे जसले अवसरको समुद्रमा के भयो बेरोजगारीको कालो अन्धकार मात्र देखिरहेको छ होइन भने के को कमी छ र हाम्रो देश नेपालमा एसियाले उज्यालो बनाउन सक्ने जल स्रोत छ हरियो वन पाखा छ अनि यही नै छ विश्वका पर्यटकहरूलाई लोभ्याउन सक्ने सुन्दर हाम्रो कला अनि संस्कृति हिमालबाट छल छल्ती बग्ने पानीहरूलाई वाटर अफ हिमालयन्स भनेर सप्लाई गरियो न महोदय एक गुटी खाँदाखेरि कतिखेर मेरो देश भन्ने भन्छ पत्तै पाइँदैन हो महोदय म त्यही देशको छोरी हो जहाँ ब्याचलर अनि डिग्री गरेका सर्टिफिकेट बोकेर हजारौँ दक्ष युवा जनशक्तिहरू 7,000 जनाको कोटामा 74,000 जनाले जापान अनि कोरिया जान फर्क परिरहेका छन् हो म त्यही देशको छोरी हो जहाँ मेरो बाबाले 18 घन्टा काम गर्नु भएन भने मेरो यो बदनमा कपडा हुँदैन हो म त्यही परिवारको छोरी हो जहाँ मेरो एउटा 9 वर्ष भाइ सानैदेखि ब्रिटिस आर्मी भन्ने सपना देख्छ कहिले नेपाली आर्मी बन्छु भन्दैन दिन दहाडै भइरहेको बलात्कारहरूले गर्दा डर लाग्छ महोदय कि बिहान अफिस हिँडेँ कि मेरी दिदी भरे साझा घर फर्किन्छन् कि फर्किँदिन हो डर लाग्छ मेरा आमा बुबालाई दिन धक धक गर्दै कति मेरी छोरी कुनै पिसाबको हातका लागिनन् म डराउँछु महोदय घरदेखि विद्यालय जानसम्म पनि डराउँछु कसैले साँच्चीकै माया दिएको मिठाई लिनदेखि पनि डर लाग्छ महोदय मलाई आफै पहिलेसम्म जुन दिन लैङ्गिक विभेदको अन्त्य हुन्छ हो त्यो दिन साँच्चीकै म गर्वले आफ्नो चिज ठडाएर भन्नेछु कि हो हामी सबै युवाहरू एक भयौँ र अन्त्यमा पहाडमा जानु बढे तराईले छेक्नुपर्छ तराईमा आदि आए पहाडहरूले छेक्नुपर्छ यदि यसो होइन भने राष्ट्रियता छैन हामीभित्र माटोलाई चोट पर्दा मुटु हाम्रो धुनुपर्छ जय युवा जय राष्ट्र धन्यवाद निकै नै जोरदार प्रस्तुति दिएर भइसक्नु भएको छ कन्टेस्ट नम्बर 5 ले अब निम्त्याउन चाहन्छु कन्टेस्ट नम्बर 6
हेलो गुड आफ्टरनुन एन्ड नमस्कार एभ्रीवन आई एम कन्टेस्ट नम्बर 6 आकृति काफ्ले
संस्कृति यही महान पहचान हो कि म स्वाभिमान नेपाली चेली म कर्मठ वीरको खाली साहस चेली म प्रतियोगिताका साथ समीक्षा नेपालको तर्फबाट हजुरहरु सम्पूर्णमा न्यानो अभिवादन आज म कविता भन्न गइरहेको छु मेरो कविताको शीर्षक रहेको छ मेरो देश देश मेरो बाँचेको छ त्यसैले म बाँचेकी छु मेरो श्री जोश र जागर देशका निम्ति साँचेकी छु के समुद्रको गहिराई के सगरमाथाको उचाइ अद्भुत छ यसको प्रकृति अतुलनीय छ मेरो देशको संस्कृति अद्भुत छ यसको प्रकृति अतुलनीय छ मेरो देशको संस्कृति उनिएका छौँ हामी एउटै मालामा बसेका छौँ हामी सिङ्गो नेपालमा मेरो रगतको हर थोपामा रिडियो माटो अपदेशलाई प्रेम गरौँ हे दुर्व्यवहारको साटो अपदेशलाई प्रेम गरौँ हे दुर्व्यवहारको साटो कर्मठ वीर गोर्खाली साहसी चेली शान्तिका दूत गौतम बुद्धको मेरो देश हेरौँ एकपटक देशलाई प्रियसी बनाएर हेरौँ एकपटक देशलाई प्रियसी बनाएर हर कोहीले राख्नेछ हामीलाई दिलमा सजाएर हर कोहीले राख्नेछ हामीलाई दिलमा सजाएर धन्यवाद
कन्डिसन नम्बर 8 लाई अब भनि म मिटमा चाहन्छु स्टेजमा
गुड आफ्टरनून एन्ड नमस्कार एभ्रीवन आई एम सलोजा रिजाल कन्टेस्टेन्ट नम्बर 8 Proudly representing Sagarmatha Residential School, my temple of knowledge, wisdom and God. Today I am going to deliver a speech about women empowerment, balance for better. Woman is a beautiful creature of the world. She is the most beautiful creature of the world, the most best inspiration, motivation for everyone. Behind every successful man, there is a woman. We believe that, yes, there is woman. Look in front of us. There is our judge, and she is woman. She is leading us, she is judging us, and she can do anything. If we try to do anything, we can do everything. Because women are only the creature made by God who can inspire everyone to do something new in our nation. So, see, you can change your pants into cans, and your dream into plans. So always be creative, always love yourself, try yourself, empower yourself to be the best motivation of the world. You can do everything what you want and you are the only God of our nation. If there is a man in front of us, there is always woman. She can be our mother, sister, daughter, everything. So always remember woman. So raise your voice against a rapist. There is a God, a mother God, a God. She believes that she can do everything, but every voice, they think they can't do anything, then they start to touch them. They are being raped, but we are not raising voice against them. Why? Why in Nepal we are getting down? We are getting lower because we are not raising voice against them. We should raise voice against them. Many of us girls are not getting opportunity like us. We are getting in front of your head. So we should give equal opportunity to everyone. We the women can do anything and we the successful person, be the women, be the pride of our nation. We are only the inspiration to everyone. A mother who struggles every day to do something new. See, do something new to do better every day. If a woman have to bleed every day for 7 days, she has to bleed every 7 months, a year. She has to bleed 7 days non-stop. If a man, one man would bleed only for 2 or 3 hours, they would definitely die, I think, right there. Can do.
9, proudly representing United Gorkha Academy School, Kharan. And I'm going to perform a dance, Jawari. Thank you.
It isn't the fault of the man. It is the fault of the girl. Yes, the society. on hearing them, I became numb. A question floats in my mind. Has it a fall of the ground? Is it a sin to be a girl? Or is a sin that she committed? Whatever, listen all the silence, girl. Stop the silence. Stop the silence. Speak out loud and be the sound. Be the bravest and make yourself proud. You are who you are. You are a girl and it's a blessing. Thank you.
Contestant number 12.
Namaste Dharan. Myself, Susmita Thapa, contestant number 12. Representing Siksha Sangha Secondary Boarding School. And the judge of my song is Huari Jamuna. Thank you.
Mitha, mitha, kura, sumo. नौ मिठाई जगह फर्क आऊँ कहीं नलुकाए कुरा गर्छन् सबैले आफै ठुलो मान्छे जय गरी जोस तर भन्नु पर्दा सबैको हराएको छ दोष यी सबै कुरा हुन्छन् हामी माझ किनकि यो हो हाम्रो समाज थ्याङ्क यू
जब एउटा पुरुष शिक्षित हुन्छ तब ऊ मात्र शिक्षित हुन्छ तर जब एउटा नारी शिक्षित हुन्छ तब पुरै समाज नै शिक्षित हुन्छ नमस्कार म साक्षी वाग्ले प्रतिस्पर्धी अङ्क 14 मैले आफ्नो एसी परीक्षा विष्णु मेमोरियल सेकेन्डरी स्कुलबाट दिएकी हुँ आज म एउटा कविता वाचन गर्न गइरहेकी छु मेरो कविताको शीर्षक रहेको छ तिमी को हौ र यो यस प्रकारको छ तिमी मलाई सोध्दैछौ म को हुँ भनेर सायद तिमीले मलाई चिनेनौ होला आऊ म तिमीलाई चिनाउँछु म को हुँ भनेर म त्यही निर्मला पन्तको मन हो म आफ्नै बाबुबाट बलात्कृत भएकी 8 महिनाकी बालिकाको हृदय हो म हरेक नारीको डर र चिन्ताको साक्षी हो म हजारौँ होइन होइन लाखौँ बलात्कृत भएका चेलीहरूको आवाज हो म त्यो नारी हुँ जो आफ्नो कुजिएका पखेटालाई फिजाउन जान्दछ जो आफूलाई सिटमा सबै समान ठान्दछ म त्यही नारी हुँ जसलाई हिराको हारभन्दा सिटको हार पहिरिन मनपर्छ हो म त्यही नारी हुँ म त्यही नारी हुँ जसलाई अहिले पनि गर्मीले तुलिन्छ दाइजो नल्याएकोमा कुटिन्छ र जिउँदै जलाइन्छ म त्यही नारी हुँ जसलाई छोरी जलाएकोले हेपिन्छ र एक्लै छाडिन्छ हो म त्यही नारी हुँ जसलाई तिमी आमा भन्छौ जननी भन्छौ सृष्टिकर्ता भन्छौ तर इज्जत दिँदैनौ म त्यो नारी हुँ जो हजारौँको भिडमा हराएर होइन भेटिएर बाँच्न चाहन्छ जो औँसीको रात जसरी होइन पूर्णिमाको रात जसरी बाँच्न चाहन्छ हो म त्यही नारी हो जो समाजमा आफ्नो अस्तित्व बनाउन चाहन्छ तिमीले अझै मलाई चिनेनौ होला म त्यही स्वाभिमान नेपाली छोरी हुँ जो तिमी जस्तो अत्याचारीको विरोधमा लड्छु जो तिम्रो नारी र पुरुषलाई भेदभाव गर्नुपर्छ भन्ने सोचलाई वास्ता नगर्दै अगाडि बढ्छु हो म त्यही नारी हुँ म त्यही स्वाभिमान नेपाली छोरी हुँ म त्यही स्वाभिमान नेपाली छोरी हुँ हो म त्यही स्वाभिमान नेपाली छोरी हुँ जय देश जय नेपाल धन्यवाद
all of you on the challenge round of Taste Test position. In this region, the Bijapur Hills that provides an amazing view of the Dharan. Yalambar Park, Saptarangi Park are other famous landmarks that has been attracting various tourists towards the Dharan. Dharan, it is the one of the best places for the tourist destination. And talking about the Dharan tourism prospect, the Dharan tourism prospect include the paragliding from the surrounding hills and winter for the JNP's conservation of the flora and fauna of Charakudi Forest. And there are much more prospects of tourism development of Dharan. All that they should need is that unity. A major role that people can play is that people can create a unity and can contribute in the development of tourism promotion of Dharan. When there will be a unity, there will be a promotion. And when there will be a promotion, there will be a development. And about half of the majority of the population are youth here. And youth can bring a huge change in the tourism promotion of Dharan. If all the youth understand the worth of touristic places and if they can create or organize the cleaning campaigning program in near touristic areas, religious sites or cultural sites, then that can make a huge change. And if it is Dharan, it is a developed city, and if all of the people, they will be united, come on board and join for the tourism promotion of Dharan, then there will be wonders. As I have always believed in the power of unity, unity is our strength, and with the collaboration and teamwork, the wonderful things can be done. And by saying this much, I am going to stop my short speech. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Condition No. 15, Dipsy Kalimbuju.
AC year of Masega, my winning early. You, Umirma, Piti Rambo, Ahmad Shemata Production, Gorna Sopsan, Panera. मैले अन्डरएस्टिमेट गरेको रहेछु. वास्तवमा यिनीहरूको क्षमता हेर्दाखेरि त यिनीहरूले भविष्यमा आफ्नो यो अन्तर्मनबाट आएको क्षमतालाई यसरी नै नियमित ढङ्गले यसलाई यसरी नै समय दिएर तिखार्ने काम गर्यो भने पक्कै पनि यी भाइ बहिनीहरूले समाजलाई केही दिन सक्नेछ, समाजले केही पाउनेछ, देशले केही पाउनेछ. र समग्रमा भन्नुपर्दा यस्ता आजका बालबालिकाहरू भोलिका युवा हुन्छन् र साँच्चै नेपाल समृद्धतिर लम्किन्छ कि भन्ने मलाई लागेको छ. धन्यवाद.
र कार्यक्रमलाई अगाडि बढाउने क्रममा म कन्टेस्टेन्ट नम्बर 16 निम्त्याउन चाहन्छु.
गुड आफ्टरनुन एन्ड नमस्कार टु अल अफ यु. दिस इज मी कन्टेस्टेन्ट नम्बर 16 मिसु लिम्बु रिप्रेजेन्टिङ मेरिल्यान्ड इङ्ग्लिस बोर्डिङ स्कुल धरान. थ्याङ्क यु. द डान्स विच आई एम गोना डु इज Tapa dance. Thank you.
Thank you.
proud representing Sri Shaini Gawashya Mahavidyalaya Dharan. Today, I'm going to perform a dance at night. Topic is Sangeet Nach. Thank you and hope you like it.
Thank you. it brings a single voice to bring the whole women world to life. Namaskar and good morning. Good afternoon. To the panel of judges, honorable personalities of the room, respected members of the Dharmanjaisis, parents and guardians of my fellow contestants, and my fellow friends as well. I am Sonia Bajaj, contestant number 19, delivering a speech on the topic, Women, Balance for Better. First of all, let me talk about Balance for Better. Balance for Better is the theme of 2019 International Women's Day set by UN since 2012 that was started. Which says, everybody has a part to play, all the time, everywhere. But everything isn't easy as it sounds. When I look around, I don't see the same equality, balance, and support and respect that should be given to a woman. It really makes me wonder how. How giving equality and how gender equality is such a hard subject for people to do. Let me talk about some women that I saw. We all travel in a local bus, isn't it? At least once we have. In the local bus, the front two rows, the front seats of the row are always reserved for women. It is always written there. But do you even see any women sitting there? No, I don't think so. There is always two men sitting in the front row and still no one raising voice against them. If this simple thing we can't do, then how can we expect to see gender equality in the future? Let me talk about another thing. There is a room and there are two children. One baby is patient enough that he can wait until it is fed. But the other baby makes so much noise, so much loud noise, that it can't wait until it is fed. So, that is how our society is. Let me ask any one of you, what do you think? Which baby will be fed first? Of course, the one which is making more noise will be fed first. That is how our society works. The one gender bringing more noise, more loud voice, raising voice, will be given more rights and equal rights. Isn't it? And talking about gender equality, they are all of the... I've heard that grass is always greener at the other side. Imagine how better and beautiful this world will be when equal opportunities, respect, support are given to a woman. Of course, right now, the needed and required thing is equity. That is overcome by equality right now. But suppose, after that equity, how much our world will be and what we will be in some years after that equality has taken place. Can you just imagine? It sounds like a dream, but let us turn into a reality. Because when the balance is better, the world becomes a beautiful place to live in. Right now, I am standing as a woman, and let me tell anyone or every one of us here, not only men, but both men and women, that women had everything within herself when she was born. But it was the world that made her realize that she didn't. In my country, women are supposed to fill 33% of the governmental posts. But yet, the sad part is that 33% is still not occupied by the women themselves. So let us be clear that it is not only the men that are responsible for this. It is also the women that they believe they can't and they don't. So let me tell each and every woman right here, you got the power within yourselves. Balance for better is a chance that you can shine bright and have equal opportunities like men, not only in moral values, culture, but also in economics, politics, social, cultural, and everything. So let us work together for balance, for better, and make this world a beautiful place to live in. Thank you.
Rao Palamai is a contestant number 22.
Hello and good afternoon, everyone. It's me, Jenny Salpaki, contestant number 20, proudly representing Krishna Memorial Secondary School. Today, I am going to perform a dance. Maya Pirati. Hope you will enjoy it. Thank you.
Tomorrow is giving your best today. honorable teammates, guests, my fellow friends, and all the people present over here. I am Pratiksha Tabang, contestant number 22, standing in front of you all to deliver a short speech on the topic connecting entire youth. First of all, talking about the definition of youth itself, youth can be defined as the time of life when one is young, and often the time when between childhood and adulthood. But not defined chronologically as a stage that can be tied to specific age ranges. Nor can its endpoint be defined as the specific activities. Youth. There is no reason to doubt that youth saves the future of the nation. Connecting youth is the relevant subject in these present times, as if it goes hand in hand. And creative nation is dictated. The major responsibility of the straining the
thank you so much, contestant number 22. The contestant number 23, Lalo Bhagavanitana Sansu.
Hello and namaskar everyone. I am Anshu Karki, contestant number 23 from one of the beautiful cities, Dharan. I have recently appealed my SCE from Mr. Memorial Secondary School. I am here to show off some talent on the field of dance. Thank you.
I am the student of the Department of Education. I am the
खुटी भयो जस्तो लाग्दो थियो, हामी चाहेथ्यौँ एसएलजी दिएर बसेका नानीहरूले, एसएलजी दिएर बसेका नानीहरूको नानीहरूको फुर्सदको समयमा केही सिकौँ र आफ्नो भविष्यलाई उज्जवल बनाउनलाई केही सहयोग होस् भन्ने चाहिँ हामी कार्यक्रम गरेका हौँ। मलाई लाग्छ सिलगढी कार्यक्रम आयोजना आफ्नो उद्देश्य पूर्ति भएको जस्तो मलाई लागेको छ। मलाई लाग्छ यसैलाई यी नानीहरूले आफ्नो भविष्य राम्रो उद्घार गर्नेछन्। म अन्यहरू के भन्न चाहन्छु, जुन नानीहरूलाई हाम्रो भरोसामा यहाँ दिनुभएको थियो त्यो भरोसा पूर्ति भएको जस्तो मलाई लाग्दछ। किनभने अहिलेसम्म नाममा बोल्न नसकेको नानीहरू अहिले यहाँ फ्रेन्डली भाषण गर्ने भएका छन्, डान्स गर्ने भएका छन् र भविष्यमा पनि ती नानीहरूलाई अझै उत्तीर्ण भएको उज्जवल
Lamama Gaju. Thank you. Dhanyavad. Subhai.
Hard to be, born to be, born to be. Timida, as a born to be. हुनुहुन्छ तिमीलाई अझै बढ्नु सहयोग समाजसम्मको लडाइँ रहनु छ सकारात्मक सोचको बिच गोर्नु छ शक्तिशाली भइपक्रनु छ सफलताको चुचुरो छुनु छ इतिहास रच्नु छ आफूलाई सफल नारीको बिचमा गर्नु छ आफूलाई सफल नारीको बिचमा गर्नु छ अरू त धेरै भन्दिनँ म आजलाई यति नै आफ्नो ख्याल राख्ने तिम्रो दिदी अलिष्का थ्याङ्क यू
I am Samiksha Bhandari, contestant number 28, and I am representing Paradise Hills Boarding School, Italy 20, Kalahara. I am standing in front of you all to deliver a speech, and the topic of my speech is a role in tourism development in Dharan. As you all know, Dharan is a beautiful city. It has very full potential in the development in tourism. It is always being a center point for Eastern development region. Dharan is a gateway to Western development hills and a meeting point of mountainous hill to a plain Dharan. The geographical location, climate, traditions, norms and values have always been able to catch the heart of our people and being a destination for international as well as national tourists. The hill, the Bijapur hill, which the Bijapur hill of the floor where Dharan lies, many temples, shrines of both traditions and religious, shrines of both tradition and religious rituals and fairs of those shrines, Velidar, a cool city of every year around Charles Point, where once a British king Charles had came and planned its fairs and jatra, which are growing in Dharan, are being included in the tourism sector of Dharan. The gateway of Dharan, which attracts the beautiful people, beautiful tourists. The gateway of Dharan, which have been attracting a beautiful heart of tourists like Thangkuta, Tavle Zung, Makaluvern, National Park, etc. have always been included in the Dharan's importance of tourist center. Many people in Dharan of different castes, different traditions, norms, values, lifestyle are available, like Lakhi dance and Gai Jatra of Newar people, Dhan Nach of Tamang Shila of Tamang, Chandi of Rai people, Sangini of Brahmins and Chetri people have also been the attraction of Dharan. There are many prospects of the attractions in the tourism sector, like paragliding in Velidar, rafting in Kosi River, boat race in Chatara to Kosi Paris, and all. At last, I want to say is that Dharan is a beautiful city and is being developing. Thank you.
If we want to see real development in the world, then our best investment is in women. Good afternoon, everyone. Honorable guests, the panel of judges, the set of audience, and my dear friends. I am Pragya Bhandari, contestant number 29, representing Lotus Vidya Vihar Dharan. Today, I'm conveying a speech on the topic Balance for Better. But before that, I would like to give a vote of thanks to Team Jessis for introducing us with such a great platform where our leadership skill and potential are enhanced. Now, talking about Balance for Better, it is the ultimate theme of International Women's Day of 2019. Women's Day was introduced to the world by Clara Zetkin in 1911-80. Women's Day is the focal point in the movement of women's rights. It is a global day, celebrating in the achievement of social, economic, and political progress of women, while also marking a call to action for accelerating gender balance. Even UNICEF stated that gender equality means men and women or boys and girls enjoy the same rights, opportunities, resources and training, which doesn't require men and women and boys and girls to be the same. The only purpose for the introduction of Balance for Gender is to eradicate the gender inequality prevalent in the world. Despite of enormous international agreements made upon assuring human rights, women are still lacking in employment, education, training, and even in the decision making of their own house. But the woman, the beautiful creation of nature, they are likely to be the victim of domestic violence, trafficking, sexual violence, and other oppression practices. Nobody can change the fact right now that the society where we are living right now is a male-dominated society. But that's not how it works. It is really important for all of us to understand that both male and female are absolutely necessary to continue the human race on this earth. To eradicate gender inequality of a family, if the father of the family shows equity to his wife and his daughter, then the son of the family will be the role model for the extending generation. But sadly, people of the society, they always have a doubt on women's capability and the activities he does. But this concept is not implemented to a man's capability and his deeds, even though he's not the superior in this world. And what I have seen around me is, if there is a female driver, then there is already an anxiety among the passengers if she could take those passengers to their destination safely. If a girl wishes to be in military as a soldier, then people are surprised. And that's those types of opinion and expression shows the gender inequality around us. To an illiterate person, gender inequality is a common issue, which is not common at all. Where gender inequality prevails, progress and development degrades. Talking about in the context of Nepal, where 51.4% of women stays together, but they're still lacking to come in the mainstream of the country. They're still lacking to come even in their own society, and this is all because of very less support and more discouragement. My idol person, Malala Yousafzai, an iron-willed lady, a Pakistani activist who prioritized women's education above all. And if I choose to be like Malala Yousafzai for the welfare of the people, then my people will have a doubt on me, on my capability. But if my brother chooses to do the same like Malala Yousafzai did, then people will encourage him. People will praise him for what he has done. And that's how gender inequality is looming around us. A woman goes from miss to missus, but a man is always a master. The man brings woman with love and also with the property. The man adores her and also gives the scars of torture. And women are having faced a lot of things. My heart feels heavy as I see women being the victim of rape and domestic violence. Why can't the man feel the pain in the scream of woman? I can clearly feel the pain in her silence. At last, gender inequality is a crucial issue that we are facing, that one can't solve it. Rather, we need to put hand in hand to solve it. Balance for better is better for all. Our true religion is mankind, and respect is one of the great expressions of love, which will definitely help to eradicate gender inequality around us. So, I would like to promise myself that I will work towards building a more gender-balanced world, and I humbly request everyone to do the same. So put your hands out and strike the Better for Balance pose and make International Women's Day your day, and do what you can to truly make a difference in the society. Balance for better is the necessity. Thank you.
For an introduction to our team, Sahabhagi, contestant number 30. Please welcome contestant number 30.
Hello, namaste, and good afternoon, everybody. contestant number 30. And the title of the song in which I'm going to perform is Vijayati Satanima Dekitinimai.